Show you how to simulate a Arduino using the Proteus ISIS software. First, we'll be using the Arduino programmer, and we will use an example here. I will take, for example, this basic analog read serial. Now, given this program, I will compile it, and then there you go. You will check where is the compiled file in hex form, so that we can load it. Same thing as we load on the actual Arduino. So we will look for the file with the hex extension. We'll look for the file with the hex extension, and here it is in this address. So I will copy this one. I will copy. Okay, and I will press Ctrl C for copying the address of the hex file, and then I will minimize this one, and I will open the ISIS program. Now this Proteus program is version 7.6. This is just a demo version, so I will now create a circuit with a potentiometer connected to its analog zero terminal. So I will first look for the Arduino. And I will select here this one, Arduino Uno R3. So then I will click OK. And then this part will be showed on the screen here. And I will click on the page. And this is your Arduino. I can rotate it. Okay, so you can focus this one. And we have the A0 here, this terminal. We'll put our potentiometer here. So I will put the potentiometer. I will select here for pick from libraries, and I will put here potentiometer to search for the component. So I will select here resistor, and I will look for the this one, linear potentiometer active. For simulation purpose, this is the symbol, and we don't have a footprint for the PCB. Let's leave that for a while, and then I will click OK, and then I will put the potentiometer here. So it has a symbol of RV1, and most of the value of the potentiometer that we will be using, or usually we are using the Arduino, is 10K. So I will change this to 10K. And I will click OK. So that is now 10K. And then the center of this potentiometer will be connected to A0. And then this part, I will connect it on the ground. And this terminal, we will put to our power supply, which is power. And this power is automatically configured as 5 volts. Okay. And then we can These Arduino will not work because it is not programmed, same as the actual Arduino that same as the actual hardware. You cannot use it without the program loaded into it. And as we can remember, we have compiled one program from the Arduino programmer. So I have already copied that address of that file, and I will load this on this Arduino. So I will right click on this, and then I will click edit properties, and I will paste on this program file. I will paste it here, and I will click OK. And then I think it's already finished. It's a very simple circuit, and we will see what will happen. So I will click here on the simulation button play, and you can see there is a signal here flashing on the TX terminal, transmit terminal of the Arduino. So we can vary the voltage here, and the flashing also varies. Now, how can we see the value of the variation here? On the Arduino programmer, we can use the serial monitor. But here we can use the, I will stop this first, and I will check here what tools we have available. So here we have the virtual terminal. Okay, so I will use this virtual terminal there, and the transmit I will connect it to the receive, and the transmit I will be connecting it to the RX of the Arduino. So I will click on simulation again, and we can see now the potentiometer terminal, the wiper arm here, is connected to the 50% of the voltage. So that is why it is 512. The maximum voltage will be 1023, because it is a 10-bit, so the value will be from 0 to 1023. So if we'll vary this upside, and we have a maximum voltage of 5 volts, then that will be 1023. If we will move further here, so it is proportional, okay, the value varies, and then if I will put this 0 here, sorry, okay, we'll put this on 0 here. It doesn't come into 0 because there is a little, very small voltage here exists on this line. So we can double check that with the voltmeter. Okay, so I will select the voltmeter here. I will click first stop simulation, and then I will edit the connection here by adding a voltmeter. So we have a DC voltmeter here, and I will put a DC voltmeter here, and this thing also will be connecting it to the ground. Okay, if we'll click this for simulation, now it reads 0, but there is a small value here. So I will change the range of the voltmeter. I will change this to a millivoltmeter. So I will press stop again, and I will change this to millivoltmeter. I will put this here as millivolts. Okay. And then I will click simulation again. So there is a 5 millivolt value here. That is why it has a reading as 1. So in order to have a in this circuit, in order to have a pure zero voltage across here, I will put a, I will short this to the ground by adding a push button switch. So let's try that. So I will select the push button here. I will select push button. So here we have a push button. It's a normally open push button. I will select OK. I will add it here. I will rotate. And I will connect it same to the ground. Okay, so we will try. See, it is one, and I will push this button. Then it is surely zero. So I will close this up. I will focus on this, and I will click this again, so it became zero. So 0.05 is 0.5 is negligible enough to be read as zero already. Okay, so I will release this, so it become one again. So I will now increase again. Now the voltmeter or the millivoltmeter is overloaded because this is this has only a range of MV or millivolts. So I will stop it again. I will change again to volts. Okay. And then there you go. That is 1.5. So the values from 0 to 5. From the virtual terminal, it will be 0 to 1023. Okay, 1023. So, so this is our circuit now without the load. It depends actually on the program and the circuit that we have here on this virtual representation of the Arduino and or a simulation of the Arduino. So you cannot edit the circuit if the simulation is ongoing. You have to stop the simulation first before modifying the circuit and restart your simulation. Thank you.